Welcome and bienvenue. Welcome.
Cabaret was the first stage show that I didn't have to audition for. Hal Prince, whom I had known before, had an idea that I could play this German MC. He had a memory of someone he'd seen in Germany during that time when he was in the service. And I don't know where he got the idea, except that in Stop the World, I was in whiteface. It was sort of like a clown. And there was another kind of terrible clown in Cabaret. So I didn't know why they wanted me. It just seemed, I don't know. And Candor and Ebb were also friends. And they wanted me, so it was great. What was on the page in the stage production of Cabaret, in terms of the Master of Ceremonies, were five brilliant songs by Candor and Ebb, and almost no dialogue, and almost no specificity about the life of this character. And so I went about inventing that as a method actor always does. And Lada Lenya's wise eye, which I would always look to for, am I on the right track here? Is this really the way it was? And she was very helpful. I went down into the dregs, into the groveling of this horrific character, who was actually, you know, you have to find something to like about him. He was just trying to survive. However, he was such a terrible influence, and a Nazi, and Hitler at that time was saying to people, "I'll give you bread. I'll give you everything," and people believed him. And the master of ceremonies says, "Life here is beautiful. Come with me." And at the end, you know, the Jews are murdered. Nobody had ever seen a musical, certainly, like Cabaret until we did it. The girls were hanging off the edge of the stage with their garters, and it was very, very outrageous and sexual. And I think people forget that it was really a groundbreaker. And there were things in the show that just frightened people and, you know, thrilled them and scared them. And there was a line in the Gorilla song, "If you could see her through my eyes, she wouldn't look Jewish at all." There was such a hullabaloo and a hubbub about that line that the B'nai B'rith, or I don't remember, some Jewish organization was talking about picketing. They did not get that that line was itself a damnation of anti-Semitism. They thought it was an anti-Semitic line, which it was, but it had to do with the character and the time. And so we changed it to, "And if you could see her through my eyes, she isn't a Mieskite at all." However, there were a number of performances where I just forgot.
"She isn't a Mieskite at all.